Sports Tonight is back again. We're broadcasting live from Channels TV Sports Center in Lagos, Nigeria. Amongst in Okunakwan, it's still an action-packed, money-spinning, exciting, engaging, interesting world of sports. What are you talking about? We're still reviewing the 2016 Rio Olympics, still having in mind also that the Paralympic Games will also begin in Rio de Janeiro in about 7 days' time. So much to talk about on the program this morning. What should we talk about tonight on the show? Coach Samson Siasia says he doesn't have any business with Nigerian football anymore. You know the story. It wasn't sweet at the Olympics in Rio. And talks about unpaid salaries, unpaid allowances, and all. Then the coach says, look, I think it's all over for me and Nigerian football. We'll also take a look at what's going down at the Super Eagles camp in Uyo. You know, they're getting ready for Saturday's AFCON qualifying game against Tanzania. We said they're just playing for pride. But for new technical advisor Raw, it's another opportunity to look at the team and see ways he can work with them. We'll also, on the show tonight, give you transfer updates that concerns Nigerian players. Yes, they are also moving clubs. We'll tell you, let you know what's going on. What's going on with Aguero? Yes, we will tell you that one also. Wayne Rooney is also on the show tonight. We'll let you know what's going on, Wayne Rooney. And of course, the 2016 U.S. Tennis Open. Not much upset for now for us to talk about, but we'll give you the updates coming from the U.S. Open. So much to talk about. Let's quickly bring you into all of what we'll be doing tonight on the program. Don't just watch this show. Come, let us play for the love of the game on Twitter. We're Channels _ Sports, Facebook, Channels_Sports. You can also send an email to sportstonight@channelstv.com. We are still looking at what went down at the 2016 Rio Olympics, and we're also counting down to the 2016 Paralympics also in Rio. We want you to talk about that one as extensively as you can on Twitter, Channels_Sports, Facebook, Channels_Sports. Just to also let you know that all our top stories can be viewed on our website. It's channelstv.com and on YouTube /channelsweb. Somebody's on the go, probably in traffic, and he's saying to himself, how can I be part of the show? Don't worry, just go to m.channelstv.com, download the Channels TV app for your iPad, iPhone, your BlackBerry, your iOS, your Windows phones, and even your Android phone can do the magic. m.channelstv.com, download the app, and you'll be part of all everything that we will be doing tonight on the program. It's now 7 more days to go to the 2016 Paralympic Games in Rio. We told you Team Nigeria, they have unveiled the athletes that will be representing the country, and the likes of Hannah Babalola. You remember Hannah Babalola? Yes, you should. The lady that felt the power of sports and her life transformed. We're also taking a look at our powerlifters. Yes, they've always been impressive. They did good things at the London Olympics, and we believe they will also do the same at the Olympics in Rio. Bosse Omolayo is part of the team. Esther Onyema is there. Abdulaziz Ibrahim is part of the team. There's also Paul. Paul has been in that team for almost forever. And of course, Yakubu Adesokan, Sportsman of the Year, Nigerian Sports Award. He's still doing big things for the country. He's also part of the team. We are not also forgetting our table tennis, our para table tennis players. Ahmed Koleosho is part of the team, and Emmanuel Nick. They have been preparing these guys. They want to go to Rio, represent the country. Do you know what they want from you and I? They just want our support. So let's keep supporting the Paralympians that represent Nigeria. It didn't go so well for us at the main Olympics. Let's see. These guys might just turn it around. All they need is your support. Some guys will be supporting me tonight on the program to make it interesting. And, of course, with you, we will make it an exciting show. Cosmos Chukwuemeka joins us. It's a Tuesday evening. Cosmos, good to have you on the program.
Yeah, good evening, Austin. It's good to be back on the program.
Fantastic. Good to have my colleague, Yemi Adebayo. Yemi, good to have you join us on the show.
Always a pleasure, Austin.
And what a way to start the Paralympics. Yemi, 7 more days to go. We know these guys, they go out there, they give their best. Even with little or no support, but this time around, they're saying, guys, just support us. We can go to Rio and change the story.
We're good at that. You know, we know how to hope and pray. So we're going to do that. Give them all the support. It's a shame that we only get to talk about this when a big competition is around the corner. But we're hoping. You know, I was telling you yesterday, some of these guys are married. They have national honors already to show the impact that they've had in recent years. 23, I don't know how we're going to finish on the medals table. It's not so much about the medals that you bring, but giving this guy a sense of belonging, that's the right chance to show that life is not over. You can still do all the things that you really want to do. And I trust these guys. In spite of the fact that we've not put much into them, they will still come back, you know, give us something to cheer about.
That's right. Yemi said something very important. Inclusion. Giving them an opportunity to showcase their talents. Because some of these guys, you know, probably some unfortunate incident made them the way they are physically challenged at the moment. But sports has given them a chance. Cosmos. They can go to Rio, represent us properly, and get you and I talking.
Yeah, I mean, they did that some 4 years ago in London when Nigeria came back without any sort of medal. And, you know, they came, what the abled couldn't do, the disabled were able to do. So we just hope that they go there. You know, it has even telling their life. I mean, you have five of them. Three of them that were part of the five that were world record holders are in this team. Mm-hmm. So, they are, like you said, they have national awards and all that. They're national holders too. So, you just have to expect the best from them, despite the lackadaisical treatment from the administrators and, of course, the very, very bad preparation towards the competition. But then, you know, the disabled, what they cannot get, especially when it comes to being able to do some things, they have the will, they have the power, and they've always shown that from 1992, Barcelona 92 Paralympics, when they have been competing for Nigeria, they've gotten over 49 medals.
Wow.
So what more can you say about them? So let's just hope that on the 7th, we'll be able to start celebrating that we'll probably get several medals, golds, silvers, and bronze that the able could not do. They could only get bronze.
So. Some things must be put in place here. I mean, for instance, we don't want to hear about the unfortunate kids incident happened at the main Olympics. These guys should be ready from here. All kids should be handed over to them. You know, get them on time to leave the country to get to Rio. These are just little things you can do to really get down there and get ready for business.
Well, you know, for all of those things not to happen, you have to take care of logistics. From my experience with I've been with a crew that is close to what is going to the Paralympics, so I understand. So if you're saying 23 athletes, you should be smart enough to know that it's not just going to be 23. They are helpers.
Yes, exactly.
They're going to need their wheelchairs. They're going to need all of those things. You have to factor all of those, the training equipment. You have to factor all of those things. But also, I want to look beyond the Paralympics. You also have to... Some of these guys are breadwinners. You know, you need to see how they are welcomed at the airport. You know, when they are received... Some of their family members know that at least I'm going to get something.
Yeah,
this person is coming back. So you know that was not where any funny stories about them being told to pay certain amounts to train at the national stadium. You're looking at all of those things. The problem is everywhere globally. We must say, but we are Nigerians. We talk about Nigeria. You know, so we need to step up in the way we look at things. You know, I have a problem if we have a competition mentality. Because if you go to the Paralympics, does it end there? It doesn't.
No, it doesn't.
I hope we do well. Everybody loves victories. I love victory. Everybody does. It's good. It makes you smile.
Yeah.
At the end of the day, what do you get from it? If you jump up, you come down. That's what I believe. So we need to... you can get away with some things with the able-bodied guys, but with these guys, for them not to feel forsaken, for them not to feel that you've taken them for a ride, you have to ensure... the before and the after.
That's
and the
right.
Before and the after is ensure that you treat
them
well, ensure that the facilities are there, ensure that some of these guys can make a livelihood. Because apart from what they do, some of them are, you know, they have a calendar in their houses, when is the next Paralympics? Because some of them are involved in four para table tennis, powerlifting. Some of them do 4 or 5 events. Some of them have even crossed over to wheelchair basketball. Now they're just going around just to, you know, make out a living. So that's why I think it's important for the government to really look at this. Sports is not philanthropy.
Yeah.
You're not just giving this. These guys can really make you money if you put the structures there.
Very true.
All Yemi Adebayo is saying is welfare, and more welfare should be given to sports in Nigeria. And that's what the Ministry of Sports should start looking at. We should develop a framework where welfare will be addressed, and then a workable framework to ensure that the issues associated with welfare of our athletes is a foregone issue. Not just the athletes, coaches. Look at the story of Coach Samson Siasia and all that we're hearing at the moment. Not a good one. So we just want to wish our Paralympians all the best. We'll continue our countdown to the the games. But at the moment, let us review the 2016 Rio Olympics. So much happened for Team Nigeria. What everybody can remember is that it's just the football team that got bronze. But there are some positives. Yes, some positives we can take out of it. Aaron Akwori-Wende became the first African to make it to the quarterfinals. Chiruka Okogu rowing. Who talks about rowing in this country? She rowed her way into the semis. We need to work towards ensuring that she gets better. That's Chiruka Okogu there. She is about just 23, and she did well at the Olympics, ranked 20th overall in the world. Chiruka Okogu needs more support. She needs more development. The federation also needs to develop more Chirukas to go into rowing. We spoke to Jonathan Akinyemi on the program this morning. Canoeing and slalom. He's disappointed he didn't have a good outing, but hey, we told him to forget about that. And look at the positives. He's pleased that the sport is getting some awareness now in Nigeria. So Jonathan Akinyemi is saying, guys, that it's time to go back now, look at the youth, find ways we can start developing this type of event so that more people can be part of it.
Yeah, we pretty much said so last week when I was here on Sports Tonight. We pretty much said so on the fact that this sport, this water kind of sport, is not particularly popular in Nigeria. But then we talked about the fact that you have these natural facilities, if I will put so. I mean, we've got the lagoons, we've got the ocean, we've got the sea, especially in Lagos and of course in some parts of the Niger Delta, that we can annex this. We've got the facility, the natural facility, but now it has to take the wheel, the wheel from the sports administrators and of course from lovers of this sport to do something. I mean, look at a certain Chiruka Okogu. I mean, got to the classification final, finished second.
Really,
I mean, this is somebody that had to stop medical school for a while just to raise funds for herself, qualify despite no support, qualify, got to Rio, and did Nigeria proud.
She got some good support. That's she got some good support.
She got some support.
Supported her. The minister, I know the federation also support, but that's not really the issue, because a lot of people understand that most athletes paid their way or gave some sort of sacrifice to be at the Olympics. But yeah, I mean, the lesson is that you and I, talk about rowing, but the Olympics has given us an opportunity to talk about it. So the federation must not go to sleep. We must do more work.
Yeah, more work. We have our work cut out for us. It's not time for us to sit back, cross our hands and fold. I listened to NFL the other time. He was here and he said he has given up on Tokyo. I want to tell that like seriously.
Why?
I want to tell that like seriously. There are things. Like, for instance, if you're thinking of gymnastics, 4 years is not enough. There are some sports, 4 years is not enough. So if what you're thinking of is just participating, 4 years is okay. If you're, for instance, if our project is to get someone that's going to break all the records ever set by Usain Bolt, I still think 4 years might not just be enough. So what targets, that's the key.
In 4 years.
It's easy for us here to start making recommendations, but you're not a member of, you're not from the sports industry. So what are the targets? We can now sit down and say, this is how we can get to where we're going from this point that we're in. For instance, you talk about the sports that involve water. I beg to differ a little. Natural ability is different from technique.
That's right. Mm-hmm. I agree.
You can select guys who probably live in water all the days of their life. You still have to teach them the technique.
Don't just jump into water and beat Michael Phelps.
Possible. You have to start. So I'm thinking we need to sit down, look at our short-term and long-term goals.
I agree. I agree. Before we go on a break, me, Cosmos, what we're saying is we can remind the sports ministry that there are positives. If we work on Ese Brume from now to Tokyo 2020, if she's jumping at these Olympics and finishing fifth, she can get bronze, she can get silver, even if we don't want to dream about gold.
Yeah, that's true.
Toby Amusan, the 100 meters hurdler, she didn't do badly, and she's young. Ese Brume is young. Olamigoke Olumide is young. Sheyi Ogunlewe is young. Divine Oduduru is young. It's just that we abandon these athletes and wait
6 months to the Olympics.
And then we start working.
And we throw money at them. Throw money at them and expect them to give you a medal.
Mm. Yes, exactly. And it's so sad. I mean, based on what he said, let me key into what he said. Recently, I was talking to the president of the Taekwondo Federation of Nigeria, George Ashira, and he told me, simple, plain.
All right.
The Olympic is an 8-year plan.
We'll come back to that. That's it. It's long-term planning for the Olympics. We'll go on a quick break now. When we come back, there's still table tennis on the menu. And of course, we'll find out what's going on at the Super Eagles camp. Don't go anywhere. Stay.